Hello everyone, in this video we will read chapter 7 Glimpses of India, class 10th English book, first flight. In this video I will explain summary of this chapter in English, and very soon I will make a video in Hindi explanation also. So in this chapter we will study glimpses of India. This consists of three parts. First one is a baker from Goa, then Coorg, then tea from Assam. So these three are from different parts of India. So in the first part is a pen portrait of a traditional Goan village. Baker or Peter, who still has an important place in Goan culture, although the Portuguese have left India long back. So jo bakery culture, there's a strong bakery culture in Goa, which was introduced by Portuguese. In the second part, is a pen portrait of Coorg, which is a coffee country famous for its rainforest and spices. So in second part, we will read about Coorg, which is a coffee country of India, and it's also famous for its spices. And in the third part, we will study tea plantations of Assam. So let's start. Bread making in Goa. This is a pen portrait of the traditional Goan village baker, who is still remembered by Goans. Bread making started from the Portuguese days. They were the lovers of bread. Bread making was an art which indeed perfection. Making, molding, mixing, molding and baking were the areas of specialization of making bread. The loaves were baked in time tested furnaces. This profession has been continued by the baker's descendants. So descendants are the offsprings. As you are descendant of your grandparents, your parents, like that. So in Goa, the culture of bread making has been bought by Portuguese, and now still that is in culture of Goa. Now we will read author's childhood days. Author remembers his childhood days when the baker used to be their friend, companion and guide. He used to visit twice a day, once in the morning during his selling hours and then again while returning after selling all his bread. The jingling thud of the bamboo he carried woke them up in the morning, and they ran to meet and greet him. They ran for getting the bread bangles, which were specially made sweet bread. Now delivering the loaves. As the baker came, he would call out the lady of the house and wish her good morning. The children would be pushed aside and the loaves would be delivered to the maid servant. The author recalls the aroma of loaves that filled the air. Children would not even brush their teeth and ate bread bangles made of bread with tea. So importance of bread in traditional ceremonies. We will now study what is the importance of bread in the life of the people and their traditional ceremonies. Various kinds of breads were very important for all occasions. No marriage was complete until and unless the traditional bowl was served. The lady of the house, on the occasion of her daughter's engagement, would prepare sandwiches, and bolinhas would be prepared for Christmas and other festivals. So bowl and bolinhas are the very varieties of bread. The baker was usually dressed in a kabai, a long frock reaching down the knees, or a shirt and a trousers which were shorter than full length ones and longer than half pence. Even today, if anyone dares to go out in the street wearing half pence, he is referred to as a padar, or can say he is referred to as a baker. Now, bread making is a profitable profession. The bread maker usually collected his bills at the end of the month. All the accounts were written on the wall in the premises with a pencil. It was a profitable profession during those days, but Portuguese were lovers of fresh baked bread loaves. The baker, his family members and his servants looked prosperous and happy. So in this part we have studied about how the bread making was popular in Goan culture. So let us see chapter highlights what we have seen in a very summarized way. The Portuguese in Goa were lovers of bread. Although those eaters of bread have now gone, but its makers still exist. During the childhood days of the narrator, a baker used to be their friend, companion and guide. The baker came twice a day, once in the morning and again while returning home after finishing his selling. The jingling thud of the baker's bamboo woke up the sleeping children. Children would peep into baker's basket for the bread bangles. The children would eat bread with hot tea. The loaves were delivered to the servants of the house. Marriages were incomplete without popular bowl bread. Bolihas was a must during Christmas and all other festivals. Bakers wore a particular knee-length frock known as kabai. Bakers collected their bills at the end of the month. Baking was a profitable profession. Bakers had a plump physique testifying to this. So in this part we have studied Goan culture of bread making. Now we will see second part, which is about Coorg. So in this part, Coorg, a heavenly place. Coorg district of Karnataka lies between towns of Mysore and Mangalore. It is like a heaven on earth. It is inhabited by marital men, beautiful women and wild creatures. It is a small district of Karnataka. It consists of evergreen forest, spices and coffee plantations. The best season to visit Coorg starts in September and continues up to March. Weather in Coorg is pleasant during those months. So, weather in the Coorg is quite nice during September to March. So, this is the time when we can visit Coorg. Now, we will study people of Coorg. The people here are possibly of Greek or Arabic descent. According to legend, Alexander's army moved south along the coast and settled there only when they were unable to return to their country. These people married among the locals, and their culture can be witnessed by their marital traditions, marriages, and religious rites. The Kodavus wear a long black coat with an embroidered waist belt known as kupia. It resembles kufia worn by the Arabs and the Kurds. So, here we have studied the dressing of Coorg, how the people there dress. So, in this we have told that the Alexander's army had marched towards south and they were not able to go back to their countries and they settled in this part of India and they married local people. So we see a mixture of Indian cultures of Indian Mysorean area and the culture of that Arabic type region. So now bakery tales of Coorg. Now we will see bravery tales, how brave these people are and those tales. Coorg people are well known for their bravery. Coorg Regiment is one of the most decorated regiments of Indian Army. General Karyappa, the first Indian Army chief, was a Coorgi. Even today, only the Kodavus are permitted to carry firearms without license. So, Kodavus are allowed in India to carry firearms, means guns, without license. So, in this part, we have studied about how brave the Coorg people. Wildlife in Coorg. Coorg is a home to a large number of wild animals and birds. Mahaseer, a large freshwater fish, is found here. Kingfishers, squirrels and langurs live without any fear. Wild animals enjoy being bathed and scrubbed in the river by their mahouts. The river Kaveri gets its water from the hills of Coorg. So now, Coorg is a tourist place. Even the laziest tourists become adventurous on coming to Coorg, as it is full of adventure sports like river rafting, canoeing, rock climbing. The climb to Brahmagiri Hills brings smile to many faces, as one can see the panoramic view of Coorg from here. India's largest Tibetan settlement at Bailakpur is inhabited by monks in red ochre and yellow robes. There are many more surprises waiting at Coorg for the tourists to discover. Now, reaching Kirk, what happens when the author reaches Kirk? So, Kirk can be reached, or the author is telling how we can go to Kirk. Kirk can be reached by road and by rail. If one prefers to go by air, then the nearest airport are Bangalore and Mangalore. By road, it is around 250 to 260 km from Bangalore. Now we will see short summary of the Kirk part. Kurgurkugadu, the smallest district of Karnataka, is a heavenly place. Best season to visit it is from September to March. People living there are probably descendants of Arabs or Greeks. Their culture is apparent in their marital traditions, marriages, and religious rites. The Kodavus wear a long black embroidered coat called kupia. Kirk Regiment is one of the most decorated regiment in Indian Army. Kodavus are the only people in India permitted to carry firearms without a license. River Kaveri begins from hills and forest of Kirk. Variety of plants, birds and animals can be seen there. Place offers a number of adventure sports for the tourist. Tibetan monks are among many surprises that can be seen in Kirk. So now we will see third part, tea from Assam. Rajveer's visit to Assam. Rajveer and Pranjal are traveling to Assam by train, as Pranjal had invited Rajveer to visit his home during summer vacation. Rajveer is very excited to see the beautiful scenery and greenery of tree plantation outside. Rajveer tells Pranjal that over 80 crore cups of tea are drank every day throughout the world. So the beautiful tea gardens. Rajveer looks at the scenery outside, is mesmerized by its beauty. The view from the train was also very beautiful. There was greenery outside. Soft green paddy fields gave way to tea bushes. Tea bushes spread as far as I could see. There are many legends about discovery of tea. The Chinese legends say that when a few tea leaves accidentally fall into boiling water, which the emperor tasted and liked, the tea making started. Indian legend tells that a Buddhist monk cut off his eyelids because he felt sleepy during meditations. 10 tea plants grew out of these eyelids. The leaves of these plants, when put in hot water and drunk, drove away sleep. Now, Rajveer told Pranjal that tea was first drunk in China. Words like chai and chini are the Chinese origin. From China, it spread to Europe and then to Asia. Earlier, tea was drunk more as a medicine than as a beverage. The boys alienated at Maraini Junction. Soon they were driving towards Dekhya Bari, the tea garden managed by Pranjal's father. Groups of tree pluckers with bamboo plucking and the newly sprouted leaves could be seen. Everywhere, the best tea is obtained during the period of May to July. So we have seen summary. Now we will see highlights. Highlights of the summary that we have seen. So Pranjal and Rajveer were visiting Assam by train. Rajveer was busy looking at the beautiful scenery outside the train. It was green everywhere as far as the eye could see. The soft green paddy bushes gave way to tea bushes. Assam has the largest concentration of tea plantation in the world. Chinese are said to have discovered tea. There is also Indian legend saying that a Bodhidharma discovered tea. From China, tea came to the European countries and then to Asian countries. Pranjal's father managed the tea garden. There were many tea pluckers around the tea bushes. Best time is to obtain the tea leaves is between May and July. So we have seen summary and summary highlights of all the three parts of the chapter. So thank you so much.